And here's how you create a TMS WebCore application using TMS XData as the backend and as to act as the bridge between the web front end and the database. In this quick example, I'm going to use the Northwind database. I have this database here in my SQL server, local SQL server here. Here's the database, the tables. Here is one of the tables that we are going to use, which is the customer. Here is data. And the first thing we want to do is create the XData server. So we're going here to File, New, Other, choose TMS Business, and New TMS XData Server. We can choose here from to the full VCL application. Here will be the address of my XData server. So port 2001/TMS/data, use default. I'm going to use FairDAC to connect to my, from the plenty of options I have to connect to my database. The database will be SQL Server, and the wizard will create the initial server for us. And here it creates a FairDAC connection. I can double click it and configure the database connection as we are used to with FairDAC. If you use a different one from FairDAC, you just use whatever you want. Here's my database configuration, the server, and authentication. If we test here, it will confirm that we can connect to the database. Let's remove login prompt. And one thing we have to do here is to allow my server to connect from different domains, because we are testing here in different domains. This is optional. If you have your application in the same domain of the API, that will not be needed. And our server is done here, the source code, but we need to add the classes, the ORM classes that represent the database. In some frameworks, you have to type the classes all by yourself. But here we have the data modeler tool, which can import our database structure and generate our Redis classes for us. So for example, new import from database. I can ask for a new connection to the SQL server. I set the same settings here to connect to the database. This is my database settings. Choose the Northwind, test connection, OK, and import. Let's overlook here. So this is, here is my tables here, all my tables in the database and imported with fields and foreign keys, etc. And I can choose this TMS Redis export. And then I want to create my unit with it. So let's type the unit name Northwind here. And note that we have plenty of options here to configure my outputs, but we are going to use the default. Let's output that unit to directory trash here. And if I go back to my server, I can simply add my unit that I have created in my folder trash. Here is Northwind. And okay, it's that unit generated by the data modeler is added here. Here are all my classes. You can see the T customers here, for example, with all the mapping that XData needs that we need to work with the ORM framework. And we can simply run it here, the server, and the server is running. We can check it here at the address we configure as a root. So here is localhost TMS XData. We can check, for example, our data here. Let's take the first top two customers in the database. Here it is. So server is working. Now we are going to create our web client. Add new project. TMS web, TMS web application. So the magic is done at the server side. And we are going now to do it at client side. Here is my web form. Here is the unit of my web application. I need a TMS XData web connection to connect to my server. All it takes is to type the root address. So it's the same that we used, localhost TMS XData, and try to connect, it's connecting. So we have now all the data here, the metadata here. Next, we can use XData. We have a web client here that we can use for a more flexible connection, but we can use web dataset, which is more RED and Delphi-like. Drop a dataset, connect the, assign it to the connection, and we can choose here the entity set name that it brings for us. So here's all the entity sets available in the server. We can choose customers, and it's configured now. Now it's like using Delphi with the way we are used to. Web data source here, connect to the data set, and that's it. Now we can use one of the many dataware controls available for TMS Web Core. I like to use one that is very simple. It's WebDB Table Control. It's simply it generates a table HTML, which is very simple but very flexible because we can easily add styles and do simple things with it. It's very, between quotes, low level JavaScript. So we can assign here to the DB control to the data source. And that's it. For example, in the web data set here, we have all the most of the features we have for regular data sets. We can, for example, add fields. Here are the available fields between quotes. It's coming from the database through the XData server. So just like with dataset, we can add fields here, change display label, change width, everything works the same way. We can remove fields, for example. Let's show only until field city. And the last thing, the very last thing we need to do is, since JavaScript is all asynchronous, the XData web connection will connect asynchronously. So when the onConnect event, we can we are sure that the server is connected to and data metadata is loaded. Then we can simply call XData web dataset 1 load. And that's it. Let's run the application and see what happens. And here is our data. This is a regular table HTML tag with data retrieved from a REST server API, which is bringing from the database. And we did that all with just data sets and data source. And as I said, of course, we can change the controls. For example, instead of web table control, there we can use a FNC grid. Then a grid adapter. The grid adapter we just connect to the data source, activate it, and let's drop a button here. I will show you how to, one last thing also. A web button here. Name it apply updates and call XData web dataset 1 apply updates. Let's run. Then here you have a different control. Instead of a table, it's a complete FNC full feature grid. And this one is nice because it's very straightforward now to edit data. Now if you go back here and edit, let me show you the network activity here. If I change Rodrigo to customer 1 and this one to customer 2, and note that no network activity, it's that changes are only in memory. If I call apply updates here, we will see that it has been 2 PUT requests to the proper address. So here is PUTs to customers ALLF key I with the data that we have changed here. And if we check in the server directly here, we see that such data has changed. So this is, to conclude, this is very nice. The fact that we drop it connection, a database, data source, use it a grid, and but actually what it has done is created HTML, JavaScript, created a pure table HTML tag, and for the database connection, it's just, even though using dataset and data source, it's regular REST API requests with all that we need with the proper, the right architecture to work with, REST API, JSON requests, REST requests, JSON response, etc. And that is very nice. So that's how you connect your TMS Web Core to your preferred, to your favorite database server through Xdata very, very quickly. Thanks for watching, and try TMS Web Core and Xdata visiting our website tmssoftware.com. Thank you.